The E-League Premier quarterfinals and the playoffs upon us, taking place over the entirety of next week. Esports Pools have made an exclusive fantasy pool with my name on it, Thorin's E-League Premier Fantasy Pool, and it's free to enter, and they've got hundreds of dollars worth of skins. Like, the first place prize is some sort of a gut knife. I mean, we'll get into that at the end of the episode, because I'll pick my fantasy team and I'll show you who I think the stars of the tournament will be. So the E-League Premier playoffs are upon us. The entire playoffs take place from Tuesday to Friday. You have the first two quarterfinals take place on Tuesday. Wednesday, you have the other two quarterfinals. Thursday, you have the two semifinals. And then Friday, you have the grand final itself. Now, for me, E-League is a massive event. It's one of the biggest events in the calendar. I think in terms of prestige, it is only below the majors. I can't elevate it past a major just because, like, the majors are truly global qualification system. You don't have online qualifiers except prior to minors, etc. I think it's just a better system to get the top teams there. I also think that E-League Premier actually has a better format than majors, though, except that the way that they had to run the groups this time, where they had to let certain teams go to tournaments on certain weeks, and so they had to make the groups based on who was available, didn't lead to some ideal groups. I thought groups A and C were kind of whack, actually, groups B and C, rather. The Immortals, North one, and then the one where it was Envious and Nip and those guys, whereas I thought that groups A and D were pretty stacked, actually. And some of those teams, as much as Na'Vi, yes, has since gone on to shit the bed and not be very good, they would have been very competitive in another group. And I definitely think SK and Team Liquid are actually two of the better teams in the world right now, and they didn't make it out of group D. I think both of those teams would have made it out of groups B or group C, in my own opinion. So I think it's very good that there's so many good teams here. So many good teams have also made the playoffs. There are a couple that are a bit questionable, but all the top teams pretty much are there. There's no SK, there's no Team Liquid again, teams that would have had chances to go far in the tournament, but you still got FaZe, Astralis, G2, North. You've got some very, very good teams finally facing up again. So we haven't seen some of them play since Malmo, so a couple of months ago. Now, in the first matchup, we've got C9 versus G2. These boys. So you know who I'm going for on this one, because I actually do think G2 is the better team here. I think it's a big problem for C9. First of all, that they have one of their better factors for C9 is skill. Is that in theory, skill-wise, they can match up with most teams in the world. Problem is, G2 has a lot of skill. They're very deep in terms of skill. Their worst players at the moment are actually Shox, and at the moment, in terms of current form, I'd say Body. And those players are pretty skilled, actually, especially when you consider, frags aside, Shox wins clutches, even in his current dilapidated form, and so he's still dangerous and has impact upon your team. Now, a big factor for this, and for the whole playoffs for G2, is if they maintain that economical sound financial strategy that they had at Malmo, which I thought was fantastic and really unlocked the last gear to G2. If they do that here, I think they're going to win the whole tournament, never mind just this matchup. And so I definitely think they will be favored against C9. I think for C9, they tactically haven't looked like they've got it together. I think they've had big issues getting Automatic and Skadoodle to work on LAN. And so that's been a problem for me, because I need Automatic to be at a very high level if I think C9 is going to be very good. And I think if Skadoodle's just useless, you're just wasting ops on him. Tarek's a good player, but it clearly takes a hit when he's the in-game leader. Stu2k is good, but hasn't been putting up those superstar numbers that people associate with him. He's been having high fragging, but his actual overall impact hasn't been as big. And then Rush has actually been pretty good, and I think is coming on strength to strength, and is a key factor to this team being very good. So they have their chances. Stylistically, it's going to be very interesting against G2. Problem is, in the map pool, I immediately see them having issues, because at the moment, the two big strengths for C9 are Mirage and Train, arguably in that order. Now, the problem is, at the moment, G2 has started to play Mirage, and thus has opened up Train to be their new permaban, and they're banning it against everyone. So I think G2 is just going to ban Train, and they're willing to play on Mirage, and actually, amazingly, they're not bad on Mirage. I would still actually say that C9 has a good chance to win a map there if they pick Mirage, but I think G2 can absolutely play it, and banning out Train is a good move against C9. It's a strong map for them. So the problem is, G2's picks can really fuck with Cloud9. Like, they can go to Cobblestone, Nuke, Inferno. Now, Cobblestone, yes, I'd say that this map C9 has chances on, because a bunch of their players have always been good on it. In fact, even the players they brought over from Optic like to play some Cobblestone. I think that they've got a chance there. Nuke is going to be C9's ban anyway. And Inferno is a map that at the moment, G2 really gets cooking on that map. They can win a lot of T rounds. They tend to win the T half on that map. So I think it's real tough. And then on CT side, they've got that nice double op setup. Kenny S is really deadly on this map. I think Inferno is a tough out complete. So I wouldn't be surprised if G2 picks Inferno. I think it'll be very strong. They can also pick Cobble. They're going to leave something like Cash out there as a potential decider. They can play a bit of overpass, even though they haven't had to as much recently. The map pool really favors them. I think C9's only real obvious edge is Mirage, potentially. And even that's not taken for granted because of the firepower of G2. So I'm taking G2 heavily to win this one. In terms of the stars of the team, I think logically, you look at the team from C9, and I'm saying that at the moment, I consider Rush that one of their star players, Stu 2K star player. The way they're using Rush is different, though. They seem to be using him in more like a lurk role, not really as a full-on entry. So I feel like he's not quite as empowered as he would be otherwise. But I still think he's been putting up good numbers and looked good in their recent games, like he's revitalized his career. Over on G2, right, just start with the first star, Kenny S. In my opinion, the best player in the world right now. Simple might be a better fragger. Nico might be more skilled. But Kenny S's level and his consistency with the AWP is utterly mind-blowing. And he gets busy on all the maps right now. So I think he's the best player in the world, therefore they've got the best star. And then add in, the rest of them tend to rotate. So I'll say Apex, if he has a strong series, that really puts the ball entirely in G2's court, and I think they go ahead and win this series. So I think they can win this one 2-0 or 2-1, but G2's moving on. Then we have, on the same side of the bracket, Astralis versus the new Fnatic. Remember, this is Fnatic with Golden and with Lecro, not with Olofmeister and Dennis, who obviously left. Olofmeister to FaZe, Dennis over to Godsend. So first and foremost, one of the problems here is Fnatic actually has been all over the place with their map pool because they're trying out this new style with Golden as in-game leader, and they seem to have really actually been banning mainly based on opponents. So Astralis, we know, can play every map and always ban Cobblestone. Now, the issue here is Fnatic themselves sometimes ban Cobblestone, so actually that helps Fnatic that Astralis is going to ban Cobblestone. Fnatic also tends to ban sometimes Nuke, so I think that would actually be a good ban here because Astralis actually have a threat to potentially pick it. Now, they also sometimes go ahead and ban a bunch of others. They've banned Inferno, they've banned Overpass. So really, the question here is, what does Astralis want to go to? I think Astralis, generally, is probably going to want to go towards their Overpass, is going to want to go towards something like, I mean, I don't think they will be scared to play Train, even though Fnatic's certainly been playing it. Or you can go towards Inferno. I think that's been a little bit more ropey. So for Astralis, they have a lot of the options here as to where they go. And I think that they should just in general be trying to pick what they think is a weaker map for Fnatic. Fnatic's been willing to play Cash, but are they strong on it? No, but then Astralis aren't really that strong on it. So I could see Astralis just going into something like Inferno, Overpass. I would say Overpass is their best pick here. I think it'll be a pretty guaranteed win. Then for Fnatic, what can they pick? Like, they like to play Train. I don't know that I want to play that against Astralis. Still a good team on it. They like to play Mirage. Also a good map for Astralis. Astralis' device is very good on that map. So I think tough out for Fnatic here. Whatever they pick is going to give chances to Astralis. I think Astralis is just going to 2-0 this series. I don't really see Fnatic being able to take a map unless they do something really crazy in the veto. Stars for Astralis. Device is still one of the best players. Very capable AWPer, especially on the maps I've named here. Especially if it's going to be something like Train, Mirage, Overpass as the maps. Dupree actually has really elevated his form the last few months. I've been very impressed with him in that lurking role or defensive carrier, whatever it is he calls it in his team. I think he's been pretty good there. Then on the Fnatic side of things, JW has been good even when they had the last lineup. He's back to being unpredictable. He's back to impact AWPing. And I think he can really, against a team like Astralis, they are going to be very disciplined, so there's not going to be a lot of edges to get openings. But if he can get in there, if he can get some crazy flanks off or some weird pushes, that can definitely make things interesting early on when Astralis is setting up those slow executes. The other player I'd highlight for Fnatic is I think Crims, since this new lineup was formed, has really started to solidify his form and become that good all-around player again. So there's some good players on the Fnatic side. I think overall, Astralis isn't a crazy firepower team at the moment, but tactically and in terms of the map pool, they're really favored here in this matchup. And I think having a tactical style like Fnatic's trying to run, it's going to work better actually against the more free-for-all style teams like the G2s or the FaZes of the world. I don't think it's actually going to work as well against Astralis. They're just better at it than you. They're better at it than you. So you're going to lose out there, probably 2-0 for Astralis. At minimum, 2-1. They're certainly going to win this series. I'm almost certain of it. So in the next matchup, FaZe, arguably the hottest team in the world, against Envious, a team who online do very well, but on LAN are actually fucking terrible. Like, out of all these teams here, they're arguably the worst. I mean, I know Heroic's in there as well, so they're battling for it, but they're arguably the weakest team in this playoffs. Especially when you consider Heroic won a best of three against SK Gaming online, the number one ranked team in the world. Envious has done nothing comparable to that in best of three series. So, problem here is Envious doesn't even have the puncher's chance. You'd think if they can just get their maps, they got a chance. No, because their main best map, the one map they seem to legitimately have any kind of world-class potential on, is Cobblestone. And that is going to be FaZe's ban. It was their permaban before. It's very likely going to be the ban now because it's so strong for Envious. So immediately, Envy's best chance is out there. At which point, Envious have to go to their next best map where they've had some good upsets, such as against SK Gaming, Inferno. Problem is, FaZe loves Inferno. If you pick that into FaZe, you're giving FaZe a chance to win on your map, and Envious has relied on winning T-sides and big performances from RPK to go against these kinds of teams. And the problem is, this, when you're playing against FaZe, they have so many mad superstar players with really good aim that you're just having RPK, a pretty reliable, stable player, peek into really superstar level talent over and over again. Now, that might work once or twice. It's not going to work against three or four guys, and you're not going to win out the T side against that CT side of FaZe. So I see this as a clean 2-0 for FaZe. I think it's a real tough position for Envious. They're not good anyway, but they can't even get any sort of edges here. Stars of the team, for me, the obvious stars for FaZe, who they should be and they are, is Nico and Guardian. Nico's one of the best players in the world. I don't mind if people think he's the best player in the world. Guardian has been much improved and his AWP has been very deadly. No one on Envious can face them because they only have Sixer as an AWPer. I don't think he's a very good AWPer. I think he's a pretty poor player overall. And they have Happy as their secondary AWP, and that is just a waste of money in my opinion. So I see Nico and Guardian, and then on the Envious side, RPK is the clear best player, and they need Scream to turn up in a big, big way and be both a fragile and be clutch if they want to be able to win this series. They're not going to win this series. It's over. FaZe is going to 2-0 it pretty cleanly. Final series is North versus Heroic. Inter-Danish matchup. I do think it helps that the Heroic players don't feel super intimidated by the North players. They feel like they're players they can battle with. I think for people like Nico and Joggy, this is a really big test. If they're ever going to show that they're going to be better than the Heroic team. I think, though, that North has a really good skill differential in the team. They have a really good map pool. And at the moment, I think they're only getting better and better with each tournament. I think North is heading towards being a top four team after this tournament. So I think they can go deep here and they can give FaZe a challenge in the next round. So the big issue is in the map ban, pick ban. First of all, North typically bans cash. Nowadays, they're willing to play train sometimes. So they ban cash automatically. Problem with that is Heroic bans cash as well. So if Heroic goes ahead and bans cash, as they have been all the time, then North doesn't have to ban cash. Now North can ban train, which is a map that actually Heroic's been playing and even beat SK on. So the problem here is who bans first, because I could absolutely see North just floating cash, letting Heroic ban it, and then North ban train and take away a strength of Heroic. Or North can go ahead and say ban Inferno instead, another map that Heroic picks and likes to play a lot. And with these picks taken out of the equation, Heroic's chances of winning go down even more, because Heroic want to play Inferno Overpass, don't mind playing a bit of train sometimes. Meanwhile, North has a very different map pool. They're going to pick Cobblestone most of the time if it's available. So if Heroic's banning cash, North will pick Cobblestone. I think that's a strong, strong win for North, even though the old versions with Glaive and then with Valde used to be very good on Cobble for Heroic. That's not this new Heroic team who've got Esetag and Juggy and Nico. They've changed up the lineup too much. So North is going to pick Cobble, or they're going to pick Mirage. They often go to Mirage. Now, Mirage is a map that, yeah, Heroic's been able to play a little bit recently. I don't really buy that Cobble or Mirage are doable for them. So they really do need to get to Train or Inferno. Now, Overpass is an interesting one, because North actually has been using their second ban team specific. So I could see North banning Overpass here just to get it away from Heroic as the potential third map. So I think, despite all the matchup elements and the fact that Heroic is a tactical team, I think firepower, they are ultimately outstripped by North. Map pool, they're outstripped by North, especially the map pools are almost opposing. I think the bans don't work in Heroic's favor either. And I think the best player is clearly on the North side in Config. So the star players for North, Config is absolutely one of the best players in the world right now. His aim is fucking unbelievable. His individual performances are really nuts right now, and he's primed to tear up a team like Heroic. Valde is a really consistent player, good fragging, but very stable play. Gonna really thrive against his old team. Joggy and Nico are the obvious stars of Heroic. Esetag's been really lackluster. Muddy's so up and down, and not so much up as down most of the time. Juggy, I actually really don't buy him as like some superstar AWPer, and I haven't really bought his performances on LAN, so I don't think he's going to do too well here, but he's had some good performances and was a big reason why Heroic got to this point. And Nico actually seems pretty legit. He's just still very young in his career. He does have good aim. He can frag well, but he's got a lot on his shoulders, especially against this North team. So I'm taking North actually to 2-0 this, or 2-1, depending on what North do with their first ban, as to whether they can have to ban cash or whether they can let Heroic ban it. So it's 2-0 if Heroic bans cash. If North has to ban Ban Kashtan, I'll say that Heroic could win a map like an Inferno or an Overpass, and we'll get to a third map. At that point in time, I think North will win anyway, and those will be the winners. So I'm taking G2, Astralis, FaZe, and North to win those matchups. And now we'll go and we'll make a fantasy team in my fantasy esports pool. So, okay, here we are. We're on esportspools.com. And so let me just change my webcam a little bit. There we go. Now you can see me. That's me, that cheeky chappy. So I'm on the website and I'm going to go up here. Fantasy, you have betting, obviously. You can bet all those matches if you think that there's decent odds. I'm going to go for fantasy pools. And here we go. Thorin's fantasy pool. Free to enter. Already quite a few entries. First place is a gut knife law, minimal wear. Second place is AK-47 case hardened. Orb lightning strike, third place. Shadow daggers, boreal forest, fourth. Stat track 5-7 and fuel injector. Got a bunch of good teams here. So I'm going to go ahead and enter this one. And as I said, so for this tournament, let me see. This is for the entire playoff. So obviously I need teams that are going far. First of all, as you might see by the shirt, I actually personally think that G2 is going to win this tournament. I think they will play FaZe in the final and I think they can win. I think their ceiling's amazing. I think some of the FaZe flaws will show, especially on CT side against the fantastic T sides of G2. So I'm going to go ahead and say I need G2 players. And the fact that when we look here, I like to go by salary so I know who I'm picking and the most expensive. Notice in terms of this, okay, Kenny S isn't even vaguely the most expensive. He's actually all the way down here at 2,100. So since I think they're going to win the tournament, I think Kenny S is the best player in the world, and I think he will be the MVP. I'm taking Kenny S as my first player. Now, as well as that, I have Astralis, I have FaZe, I have North, right? I think FaZe is making the final, but I do think North can challenge them. So look, Config's pretty expensive, though. And in this team here, Nico is very expensive. But he does put up superstar numbers. So what I'm going to do instead is, because he's so expensive, I'm going to take a cheaper FaZe player and I'm just going to gamble that they're going to have a big performance. So Olaf Meister is the player I don't really buy. Rain's been pretty good. But here's the thing. Where's Guardian? So we scroll down. Guardian's quite far down. He's all the way down here. But his form recently has been very good. So I'm going to take Guardian. I've got two Orpus here, two classic Orpus, two of the best players of all time. And Guardian is very cheap there. So now what I want to do if I can, since I think that actually North and Astralis are making it as well, I want to see who from North and Astralis I can get. So MSL, obviously I want people who can frag, who aren't bots. Look how cheap Valde is. This is nuts. So actually I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to take Valde there because I think they're making it far and I think he can also thrive against FaZe, who I think are very skilled, but once they break down on the CT side and you get into 3v3s and 2v2s, players like Valde I think will perform well and will rack up frags. I'm also going to say that I think Apex probably has to play well if G2 is going to win, so I'll go ahead and take him. He can obviously be crazy. I've got 1,800 left, so I'm going to go, wait a second, I'll pick Apex again. So for my last player, I can only pick these ones here. So let's have a look here. I can have, let's see. Who do I think? Carrigan, obviously not. Glaive, I mean, he has been really nuts online recently, but do I really buy that he's going to be that good going forwards? Carrigan, Snappy, Skadoodle, Sixer. So this is a pretty weak set of players, I have to say. I'll just go ahead and say I'll take Glaive and just assume that Astralis does half decent. I think it's a pretty solid lineup. Other options I could have gone with, right, Scream being that expensive, I think it's ridiculous. They just did very well in a bad group. I don't see that they're going to do that overall. Nico would be a good first pick. He's very likely to be the MVP of the tournament. He is the most expensive, though. I think Shox is a terrible pick. I wouldn't pick him personally. I don't think Fnatic will make it. Don't pick him. Dupree's not a bad shout. His numbers have been very good. Astralis, definitely, they have a chance to make the final. And if they place FaZe, I actually think they'll match up well against FaZe. They've got a great map pool against them. That slow, methodical pick-off T-side can cause some problems, even though the fragging firepower side's on the FaZe side. I wouldn't pick Olaf Meister personally. I think Reign's ESO on New York was a one-off. Config's a good pick. He's not the most expensive here. But you have to hope that they have a chance to at least go three maps, I think, against FaZe. I think they have a shot. I think North has an outside shot. I think they're like a 40% chance to beat FaZe. But I would go ahead and pick FaZe personally. I wouldn't pick most of the others. MBK, I think, is just too risky. He's such a smart player in terms of how he applies himself. It's not as ideal for frags. I think Device is not a bad shout. Again, if Astralis make the final, he's probably going to be a big reason why. Kirby's too up and down at the moment. I wouldn't go with him personally. AZ, I think, is terrible. He just doesn't get the numbers, so I wouldn't pick him. Stu2K, I don't think Cloud9's winning the match. I wouldn't suggest it. So there's my fantasy team. I think it's pretty good overall. For the tiebreaker, I like to put in like a reasonable one for this one, so I'm going to say 15 seconds for that one. And let's see if I win my own pool. So that's who I'm picking on Esports Pools. Remember, free to enter contest as long as you enter prior to the playoffs beginning.
Hey guys, Tempest here. Just a friendly Canadian reminder to keep force buying. And you're watching Thorin's YouTube.